Symptoms may include, but are not limited to, anxiety, low self-esteem, depression, indecisiveness, cowardice, and doubt. These are the symptoms of a debilitating disease called fear. You may have suffered from, or may be suffering from currently, if you have gotten an F in your math class, haven't known if you would fit in with everyone else at school, have felt moderate to severe depression, or have recently been going through your parents' divorce. You are not alone. Over 7 billion other people have been diagnosed with some type of fear. Consult your doctor today. Here is the problem. Fear is a disease. It comes and infects our minds anytime we feel threatened. We are crippled by its grip on our lives. But Jesus provided a cure. He eliminated any reason to fear. So here's the solution. Instead of fearing things of this world, you have to fear God. Now, you may be a little confused. Why would you want to fear God? Aren't we supposed to love him? Well, yes, of course. But fearing God is not thinking that God is scary. It is having an attitude of awe, because you understand that our great God is all-powerful and infinitely vast, and how small our issues are in the midst of his greatness. The Bible actually talks about a story that dealt with the problem of fear. A story that involves a God-fearing Israelite named Caleb during the time when Israel was about to enter into the promised land. The Israelites had sent 12 spies into the land to see what it was like, one of whom was Caleb. They returned and said to the people that the land was amazing, but that powerful giants lived there in fortified cities. Caleb still encouraged the Israelites to go into the land and to conquer it at once, but all the other spies strongly disagreed. Why? Because they were consumed with fear. The spies in Numbers 13:32 said that the land we traveled through and explored will devour anyone who goes to live there. All the people we saw were huge. When the Israelites heard this, they were terrified, and they did not want to go into the land of Canaan. So, of course, they rebelled against God. Fear infected them, and they disobeyed. For this, God punished them by promising them that everyone in their evil generation would wander in the wilderness for 40 years and die there. There are three things that Caleb had that the other spies didn't. Three things that the fear of the Lord produces in our lives. First, the fear of the Lord produces faith. Zach Poonin once said, if you fear God, you really need fear nothing else. If you put your trust in Jesus, the size of your fear compared to the size of your God is an infinitely small speck. We should be like Caleb and have faith instead of fear, because our lives are in the hands of God. No matter what your fear is, it is as meaningless as those giants were to Caleb, because God causes each and every situation you are in to work for your good, according to Romans 8:28. Second, the fear of the Lord also produces wisdom. Proverbs 9:10 says that the fear of the Lord is the foundation of wisdom. Wisdom is being able to make good judgments using the knowledge you have. Just as buildings need good foundations to stand strong, we need the foundation of the fear of the Lord to stand strong through the tough decisions we have all throughout our life. King Solomon, a man who feared God just like Caleb, was the wisest man in all history. Once we seek to know who God is, we begin to understand his will for our situations. And lastly, the fear of the Lord produces progress. It advances the kingdom of God. When we fear God, the Holy Spirit can work within us, break down our strongholds, and grow us in our walk with him. While the fear of the Lord produces spiritual growth, fear stunts it. Fear causes us to doubt God's promises to us, just like the Israelites who doubted God's promise that the land of Canaan was theirs. It was their fear that led to everyone in their evil generation to wander in the wilderness and die there. Except Caleb. According to Numbers 14:24, Caleb had a different attitude than the others had. An attitude of fear for God. So Caleb was blessed with a large portion of the land of Canaan for him and his children. He experienced progress because he feared the Lord. So this begs the question, are you fearing the Lord? Or are you just fearing God?